Hello, it's Thursday, and this week we're talking about what advice we would give to our past selves and things, because I thought that would be an interesting topic. But yeah, I don't know where everyone else is this week. Well, Diane is busy. She started, the new term started at her school, which is like busy. I don't know where Mina is though. Anyway, so what advice would I give my past self? I think I would, you know, I would definitely tell myself when I was like 8 and a half to not eat so many grapes at my grandparents' house because I was ill for like a week and I threw up all over my granddad and it didn't really give me the best impression. You know, I still think that's what he remembers when he looks at me. Some kind of small, scrawny child throwing up on them. Not cool. I'd also probably tell myself as a young child to climb more trees and to do more things like that, like run around more. Just run around more, running. Because I definitely regret not doing it enough. Not that I didn't do it at all, because I did it a lot, you know. I would say I was like Forrest Gump with the running for like most of my childhood. But I still think I should have done it more. You know, there were periods I can remember where I walked. How foolish is that? How foolish. I should have run. I don't have a clue whether I would tell myself, you know. Sarah mentioned yesterday in her video that she would tell herself before puberty to get on hormones and stuff. I don't know if I would. I don't know. I think that's maybe too big of a change in my history. I think, you know. And then I wouldn't have developed the way I did, and, you know, my teenage years, my puberty wasn't, like, horrible, it was just awkward, so awkward, and I only have, like, a few memories from it. Oh, so that's one thing I tell myself. When I was at secondary school, like, age 14, I would tell myself to step out of the way of Andrew Bissett as he came out of the geography lab. Because he, with one fell swoop of his large, fat hand, poured Sunny Delight all down me. For no reason whatsoever. Just because I was there. So I would tell myself to move the fuck away from him. I would also, you know, give advice like, don't share stuff on the bus. You know, either food or personal secrets. Because they get spread around like fucking wildfire. See, I think if I was to tell myself to start my transition earlier, I'd have to go back and tell myself other things as well, other, like, life-changing things. And then, you know, I'd be completely different. I don't really know how this whole paradox thing would work, though. Like, obviously, I don't think time travel's possible. Well, I say that I don't. I do. I've seen Doctor Who, and it's not fiction. It's not. Oh, I would tell myself about the age of 12 when me and my mum were in the car once and I think I swore by accident and she slapped me so hard. I would tell myself just at that moment, don't worry, your mum is always going to be a bitch. It's not a one-off, get used to it. Then I would have, you know, manned up. Maybe the one transition-related thing I would tell myself is that I would have told myself to get in touch with my doctor and book an appointment, or book a referral to see the psychiatrist much sooner. Because, you know, I kind of screwed around for a lot before I actually decided to do it, and I think, you know, I knew all of the time that I was still like, I don't know, I knew, but I just wasn't confident enough. And as for like the biggest thing that I would tell myself, I would probably approach myself as a young child, like 10 years old or so, and tell myself that it doesn't really matter that I don't have any friends, and I won't have any friends for many years, but then when I come to uni, I will meet amazing people, and my life will be fulfilled. So, yeah. And then I'd probably say something really corny like, keep on rolling. And my child self would look at me and think, you're an idiot. And I would go, yeah. Doesn't get better. I'll see you all next Thursday. It's Carson's turn to pick a question this week. Or next week. So that should be good. And bye. Oh, wear more dungarees as a small child, because you can't really wear them as an adult unless you're some kind of cookie? That's not even the right word. Wacky carpenter or mechanic or something. Then you can kind of wear dungarees, but everyone wears overalls. So I would say wear more dungarees as a child, because, you know. So yeah, anyway, that's my video for this week, and I should probably go because, you know, A, I kind of need the toilet, and B, I'm late, like 4 hours late.